All right, we are going to set up an ultrasonic drill. So my name's Sherman with Highland Park Lapidary. I've got my ultrasonic drill head there. I've already gone and I've pulled the amplifier out. The amplifier, you have to be a little bit aware of. It's sensitive to droppings. You'll notice when you received it, it was the big box and then the box inside there. And then this is in foam. Because this particular component, this what's called a variac in here, if it gets hit hard with a shock, it can break. So that's why we ship that double. This here, you're going to notice on the left, it looks like a little tie wrap because that's what it is. We do that because that is a ceramic magnet adjuster. You cannot put an Allen wrench in there. It's ceramic, and so having something really, really light to be able to do that tuning is important. I'll talk about that a little later. But back to the setup here, first step we want to do is I cut the straps off the box. And inside this box, you're going to then see your main components. You're going to have foam. This is the head component, so I'm going to pull my foam out. And I'll pull the foam off of the sides of the unit here. You'll see, I don't know how many pieces of foam, maybe four, five pieces. Your main drain hose right here, which I'll pull out. And then what I'm going to do is, and this would be something if you need help, get a friend to help you, lift this whole thing up and out of here. And we'll put this on our shelf. And there's our drill head here. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my foam off of here, get it unwrapped. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the shrink wrap off. Get ourselves on the shrink wrap. This is a beautiful unit. These drills, once we get into this in the training part, you're going to really dig what you can do with the drill. Ultrasonic drill is kind of the game changer. If you've done rotary drilling, you know how difficult it is to keep a piece from getting screwed up with a rotary drill. So in here, you're going to have your coolant pump. We'll show you that in just a minute. You'll have this little hose. This little hose will attach in just a second. And then you've got some fittings and some drill tips as well in this one here. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to pull this foam off the bottom. Then you'll see up on top there's some tie wraps that hold this. I'm gonna carefully cut those so as to not cut my cables. And then I've got my connector. Now, what you'll see is this connector here has five pins on the back. So we had two versions of this. There's one with a four pin, one with a five pin. This is a five pin version. That, as you'll see as I turn the camera around here, this cable connects to this outlet in the back here. So you just, there's an alignment place that'll line it up. I'll just slip it into place, find that alignment place, pop it in all the way, then I'll screw the collar on. So there we go. So we got that done. And I usually like to have a little distance between my amplifier and my piece, because this does throw some water around, so you want to pay attention to that. Now once I've got that going, my next step is I'm going to set up my little sprayer here. So the sprayer is what's going to actually pump the silicon carbide grit and the water onto the drill tip. It's actually, ultrasonic drilling is really better be considered ultrasonic, in a sense it's grinding, because in essence you're using water with silicon grit as an abrasive that then grinds the stone, a hole in the stone, using the stainless steel tip. So I'm going to put this in my place right there. And you'll note here then I got a power cord. This goes to my amplifier, which will get plugged in right now too, on the back. And it's just a standard kind of computer-like cable that plugs in the back of the unit. On the back of the unit, you'll notice there's two fuses. This is a fuse, and then there's a second fuse that's located right underneath here. So the one fuse just unscrews here, and you'll see there's a fuse that's in the end of that. Now, this is not a slow blow fuse. This is a fast blow fuse. And there, this is, I believe, double check, I think it's a over here, this, if you'll look here, this is a little compressor. compression fitting right inside. You're going to see a compression fitting here. And right there, a little compressing fitting you can see in my hand. So what I'll do now is I'll take this little brass tube, and the brass tube is designed to get me a little closer to the actual head. And I'm going to slip this brass tube into here, put my compression fitting on, and then the compression ring and then the fitting here, and I'll need to get a wrench to do that. But essentially this allows me to get my tip really close, and then what I'll do is I'll probably cut this a little bit and bend it so that my water's coming really good here. Now I'm also going to raise my ultrasonic head up. On the back here, you'll see there's a couple of bolts here. And right now the head is at the highest position, which is actually good. That's where I want it to be. So you can see you've got some travel depending on what cone you're using on this. This little hose here, the little thin hose, this is for pumping up from the pump. And we use a thinner hose because it tends to work pretty well, although we have had customers that have gone and put a little thicker hose on and had good results too. What you're first going to do is you're going to take your little hose clamps, and we're going to hook these up. Got a hose clamp here. This will go right around here, and I'm going to use a Phillips screwdriver just to tighten that clamp up. Right here. And then we're going to open up our pump, and we're going to put a hose clamp on it as well, because that's on the other end. The pump's going to go down into a small container where you're going to be putting a combination of water and your silicon carbide grit, which we'll do here in just a minute. So there's my pump. These pumps are completely badass, heavy-duty little pumps. I think you'll like the performance of these. The big thing you got to pay attention to with ultrasonic drilling when you set this up, you want to get a small enough container that the grit, it's the grit, remember, that's doing your drilling, the grit in the water. So you want to make sure that the container's small enough so the grit gets sucked back up in there, doesn't get to the outside of the pump. We'll ultimately do some type of container that's for this. I've been kind of on my brother to do a really cool stainless steel container, and he'll do it. In fact, he may do it, who knows, he may do it this week. They're on a holiday over there. He's not on holiday. Holiday this particular week, November. So anyway, we'll then tie this, put this other hose clamp on the pump down here, and snug that up. Doesn't have to be crazy tight, just needs to be tight enough. And then the last one is we're going to have this hose. This is our big hose, and this is going to go down from the back of the drill, and this is the return of the water and grit into my container. And now in my case, I'm going to just put this on my shelf underneath the unit so that I'll have my container, my pump, and everything there. So I'll show you kind of where I'm going to put this. In the back, you'll see there's this pipe fitting. Now you could also plumb this. This is definitely pipe fitting. But in my particular case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick my hose clamp around this pipe. Put this pipe on the back here and tighten that hose clamp up. And this is going to be the return for the water to come back down, the water and the grit to come back down to my pump. And we're just going to recirculate because in this case we're actually pumping up the grit to the head and recirculating back down. So pump back behind here too. And then what I'm going to use is probably going to use, I'm going to try a little Everclean container, little metal Everclean container, which will rust. It's not stainless steel, but for the purposes of this, it's going to give us a small enough fitting that we'll be able to small container that we'll be able to get pretty good flow. I set up my bucket where I've got the bucket. I just cut it down a little bit. This was a can that had been damaged.
You could also use a can, you know, from like a canning goods store, just smaller. This may be even bigger than I'd want, but it's a fairly small bucket relative to the pump, and so I should be able to have a pretty good pickup of grit as I'm using this. Now I'll get a plug strip to tie these two together.